everyone, this is Jemima from Bombay Tool Supplying Agency, Private Limited, India. In this vlog, I'll be discussing on the various tips and the right way to use a micrometer or a screw gauge. Micrometers adhere to Abbe's principle which enables them to perform accurate measurements. Abbe's principle states that a maximum accuracy is obtained when the scale and the measuring axis are in common. This is because any variation in the relative angle, theta, of a moving jaw on an instrument, such as a calico jaw micrometer, causes displacement that is not measured on an instrument scale, and this is called as the Abbe's error. You can see it in the diagram. Spindle straightness error, play in the spindle guide, or variation in measurement can cause the error to increase.
In most of the companies, the widely used instrument in machine shops is the micrometer. Micrometers are available in various sizes in both digital and analog models. Let me explain the parts of the micrometer. This is the frame, the measuring faces, anvil and spindle, sleeve, thimble, ratchet and spindle clamp or locking knob. There are two types of ratchets available in micrometers. One is the ratchet thimble and the other is the friction thimble. In certain cases, when handling the job in one hand, this can help the operator to identify that he has reached the maximum limit, and this can be identified by the ratchet sound and feel. We can use a micrometer stand to measure the component easily. Before rotating the thimble or ratchet, unlock the locking lever, clean the measuring faces with a clean cloth. Use a paper and make the measuring faces to be in contact with each other and gently pull the paper out. This can completely clean the measuring faces. Let's measure a 30mm slip gauge. While measuring, start rotating the ratchet and not the thimble as it does not indicate the optimum force. This will be useful in supplying constant force and helps to measure a component with repeatability. Use the locking knob when the part is measured and then note the reading, else the spindle might move and cause error in the readings. One of the most important precautions to take is to avoid over-tightening of the thimble, which could damage either the micrometer or the item clamped between the spindle and anvil. In larger micrometers, the anvil and spindle do not come in contact with each other. In such micrometers, setting rods or slip gauges can be used, but make sure that the value is taken from the calibrated certificate and not from the gauge. Let's preset the value on the micrometer. This is a 25mm setting rod. Press origin button to preset. Now let's measure the component. While measuring, keep the Abbe's principle in mind that even a small deviation will cause a larger error. Let's see how to take a reading on an analog micrometer. For better results, soak the equipment in the same room temperature and then proceed for measurement. As you can see, there are two sets of markings on the sleeve. The markings above the line indicate 1mm and the markings below indicate 0.5mm. We must observe which line our thimble has crossed. For example, the reading is now 10mm. Now 10.5mm. Now 11mm. Note on the sleeve scale reading, which is 11mm. We know that the least count of our micrometer is 0.01 mm. This means each line on the thimble represents 0.01 mm. We must match the line on the thimble with the line on the main scale to determine the reading. For example, here the reading on the thimble is 20, which is matching the main scale reading. Hence, the decimal reading is 0.20 mm. However, if the main scale reading crosses 0.5 mm, or in this example, it crosses 11.5 mm, then the reading on the thimble has to be noted by adding 0.5 mm. The reading now is 11.70 mm. Now let's check the value of our component. We have paused for our viewers to ascertain the value of the component. The main scale reading is 13 mm and the value of the thimble is 0.28 mm. Hence the value of the component is 13.28 mm. While storing a micrometer, ensure that the measuring surfaces are not in contact. Use the locking knob to lock so that the micrometer can be protected from any damage.
Hope this information was useful. In the next video, let's discuss on the tips and usage of another metrology instrument. Subscribe to our channel and visit our website www.btsa.in.